Although candy bars are a pretty good substitute for men. Where are our men?
Yours is in Puerto Rico, and mine is pushing cold pills in Podunk.
Lois, do you really think that Sonny could take care of Miguel's problem?
Hey, Sonny doesn't promise anything he can't deliver. Nah, he's gonna free up Miguel so that he can sign with us, and then L&B is going to have the two hottest new male singers in the business, thanks to my husband and your boyfriend.
Yeah, my boyfriend is barely speaking to me.
Oh, it was just a misunderstanding.
You know, I cannot believe that Sonny thought I was trying to get rid of him. I merely suggested that he keep you company so... Well, so you two wouldn't have to sit through the boring wedding.
Look, it was all my fault for showing up at the Quartermains like I did. I keep forgetting it's not Bensonhurst.
You know, Lois, any other day would have been okay. It's just that the family's a little... uptight about this wedding.
I understand. I just can't figure out why Sonny got all bent out of shape, you know? But it is a good sign.
How do you figure?
Well, when guys get sensitive about that kind of stuff, usually means you get into them.
Yeah, well, he's definitely getting to me. What is that?
Seaweed, Max. You want to try some?
No, it's disgusting.
Uh-huh. The point is not to look at yourself in the mirror or anything until after it's done. It counteracts all the chocolate we ate. Confuses the zits.
I know. I can already see him popping out. Oh, my God. Look.
Junk food and no sex. We'll do it to you every time. You know, I've been living like a nun ever since I became Mrs. Eddie Main.
He doesn't deserve you.
Do you think Eddie regrets getting married? I mean, because, you know, before we got married, Eddie would use any excuse he can get his hands on to come up and see me in Buffalo. Maybe the whole idea of being married scares him.
No, I think that he loves marriage. I think he can't get enough of it.
He told you that?
It's obvious, I can tell.
Good. Suddenly I don't feel so depressed.
You look very depressing. You look like some scary monster out of a horror movie.
Yeah! You can always count on your very best girlfriend to tell you the truth. Not the case.
So has Eddie seen you like this?
No! He probably freaked. No, that's one of the advantages of our crazy marriage. You get to avoid most of the nitty-gritty.
I thought that was marriage.
No, forget it. I mean, can you see me as Little Mary Homemaker, keeping the meatloaf warm and ironing Eddie's undershorts? Thank heavens that's not what he wants. No. We're made for each other.
Yeah, but don't you think maybe you're justifying?
No. Before Eddie came along, I figured I'd probably never get married, you know? I just wasn't cut out for it.
So, you mean it was your idea for you guys to live apart?
No. No, not exactly. But it's not so terrible, you know?
Yeah, well, if you're so okay with this, then I can just eat a whole box of candy bars.
I was hungry. probably Mrs. Kovac from down the hall. Her daughter, she moved to Albuquerque. She's been cooking for me ever since. If it's stuffed derma, I ain't sharing. Coming! Hey! Oh, Eddie! Oh, hi! Oh, God. Oh, God. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Hey, why didn't you call?
And wait 10 minutes on the phone when I could be here making love to my beautiful... sexy, green-faced wife? Are you kidding? I can't stay long, though. I have to get back to the dumb sales convention. Brenda.
Hi. Just give me 5 minutes and I'll be out of your way.
I'll get you a motel room.
No, that's okay. It sounds like Eddie only has about an hour.
45 minutes.
Right, you know what? I'll just go to a bar or something.
Oh, what? You crazy all by yourself?
Well, maybe I'll go to an online grocery store and get us some candy bars. Just put a light in the window when Eddie's gone.
Brenda, you're a true friend.
Yeah. Lois? Is he gone?
Yeah.
Why are you sitting in the dark? What did he do?
He made me the happiest woman in the whole world. My Eddie's the best. And I get so lucky.